Lalu Raj CM. I am leading a division in National Center for Polar and Ocean Research, Polar Cryosphere and Ice Core Studies. We study the paleoclimate using the ice core. So we often see many times that the dust, this dust particle which is laying either in the windows or in the car shield or something and that. But we never thought that, we never think this dust particle have a vital role in changing the climate scenarios. Because the dust particle which varies from micron size to the bigger sizes, the lower micron particles can even travel more distance and which can deposited over the glaciers around the world like Antarctica or Arctic and so when we drill an ice core, so we will get a record of this dust particle. They have a major impact on our climate system as well as the health system and that. So the dust particle, mainly this mineral dust, they have the direct impact like our earth temperature through a direct scattering the light waves and increasing the temperature, or indirectly it can react with the water vapor which is present in the atmosphere and like the cloud condensation and kind of things. And coming to the chemistry of the atmosphere, when this dust particle which are mainly contains the minerals or the sulfate like a phosphate or something, so when it is interacting with the water vapor and then converting into the acid like nitric acid or kind, so that to regulate the atmospheric acidity, so which has a direct interaction with the ozone, and whether it can be reduce the ozone or to increase the ozone depend upon the pH of the atmosphere. So that is so the dust particle have a major role on the atmospheric chemistry. Coming to the health side, as we know that when we inhale these dust particles, many of the microbes also going inside, so it will affect our health, especially like the Wiley fever which has happened in 1930s after the dust storms and kind of things. And another major impact is from the ocean biogeochemistry. When these dust particles are travel mostly to the to a longer distance and deposited over the ocean, and which can increase the productivity and related to the climate changes. So coming to the glacier system, what is the impact of this dust particle over the glacier system? As India, we have a lot of glacier, especially in Himalayan region or Arctic and Antarctica. When these dust particles are depositing over the ice surface, it absorbs most of the light energy and it melts the ice very fast. So when the ice is melting, it is exposing the ground surface, and which get more absorbing the light, and the atmosphere is getting warmer. So these dust particles have a greater role. Even we see it is a very tiny particle, but that have a greater role in increasing the temperature of the atmosphere. So how we can analyze these dust from the ice cores? So we are drilling the ice core, especially from the Antarctic region. We have not started the drilling in either in Himalaya or in the Arctic region. And we have a ice core laboratory at our center, and we are really thankful to our former director for establishing the ice core laboratory, as well as the present director who is helping to find a more collaborative project with the international ice core community to obtain more longer ice core records. Like to play a small movie which how the ice core is processing in our lab and okay, fine. So I'm skipping it, actually it was okay. So this is one of the data which we are presenting here from the ice the dust record which we recorded from an ice core from this central drowning mound line. So this ice core record which shows that there is a drastic increase of dust deposited in the late 20th century, especially after the 1980s. So we thought it is maybe a local deposition or something. So we compared with this ice core record with the other ice core records, which is drilled from the West Antarctic region, the peninsula region. And we found that these two ice cores showing a similar trend in deposition of ice cores, sorry, the dust records. So it is not a local deposit. So we identified that these dust are transporting from the surrounding continent of Antarctica and depositing over the Antarctic region. So we should have understood what is happening in the surrounding region of Antarctica. So we compared our dust record with the meteorological parameters around the southern hemisphere, and we found that these dust record have a high spatial correlation with the relative humidity as well as the precipitation. So these two parameters are mainly controlling the dust production over the continent. So what are the other climatic modes which regulate the meteorological parameter over the southern hemisphere? So we compared our dust with this the PDO as well as the ENSO over the time period. The PDO and ENSO are the two climatic board which is correlated to the sea surface temperature as well as the movement of the wind. So we found that when the ENSO and PDO are coming in the same phase, the arid and semi-arid regions of the semi-hemisphere become more drier, and which produces more dust. So that is why the after the 80s and most of the dust is traveling. We got a report in also the higher dust in the ice cores. So what is the transportation? Because the dust is produced over the southern hemisphere, but how it is transported over the Antarctica? So the wind is the main parameter which is transferring all the dust from the southern hemisphere to the Antarctic region. So we compared to the SAM. SAM is a direct indication of how the westerlies are intensifying or the wind speed. So we understood that after the 80s, especially the SAM is going the positive. So we checked the wind anomaly between these two periods, especially the 1948 to 2000, and which we minused from the previous 1948 to 79. So we found that the wind is drastically increased, the westerlies are drastically increased, and especially this region we can see most of this wind is traveling towards the Antarctic or where the core is depositing. So that's why this dust are mostly the dust which is produced from the southern South America, that is which I showed in the previous slide, that the meteorological condition over the southern South America was really helping to produce most of the dust. Yes, sure. So these dust were transported by the intensified westerlies and which got deposited over the Antarctic region. So what is the impact of those dust particle which is deposited over the Antarctica? So we run the radiative transfer model with the dust we got it through the 1945 or the 20th century. So what we found that these dust particle in after the 80s and all, what we understood that the atmosphere is getting warmer due to the increased dust standard. So we found that nearly 40% of decrease in the cooling rate. The decrease in cooling rate means increase the temperature. So the temperature over the atmosphere is enhanced by the deposited dust. So what is the impact over the southern hemisphere? So that we compare this our dust record with the temperature over the time period of the last 20th century, we got a very good correlation. So that means this increasing dust has some role over the increasing increasing dust has a direct link over the increasing temperature, or the dust is producing, it increases the temperature, and the increasing temperature which create more dust. So it is like a chain reaction. So the dust is, even though it is a tiny particle, which has a major role over the increasing temperature in the southern hemisphere. So this is just the recap of what I talked before. So we got a massive dust in the record. So this is the main point what I told, like the dust could increase the atmospheric temperature. So the atmosphere getting warmer and which create more dust. So again, the temperature, with that dust will increase the temperature. Thank you.